We get some real-time blasting soon, so you'll be able to see what it's like in real life. Oh shit, press on button.
Thank you.
see on a later video that I've got the wheels off this wagon, but it was dragging on a little bit this video, so I've edited it out and then we're going to put another video up just the wheels. I put one on this, but I've pressed a button by accident on GoPro and it's ended up recording it in real time, so we'll just have to do a video real time up wheels. Oh yeah, I broke three lamps doing this wagon. It's not very bright, that lamp, is it? I think, what do I do? I take glass panel off at front and then put a Perspex one on it, then gaffer tape it on. Can't really see much. Well, you can't see much with camera. I can see a little bit more while I'm in helmet. I was surprised it picked up as much as it does, to be fair, because it is a bit of a shitty job. This system I've got at the minute, it's kind of a one-man operation, so it's not the best situation, but it does the job. I don't have to keep going out to choke it up. You can just stop it and start it, and sometimes just doing a little refresh just gives you that little jolt. I've noticed as well, when the pot's too full, if you overfill it, it struggles to get settled in, and then it's either too much grit or not enough, and then you're chasing your tail, turning it up and down. It's quite hard sometimes if you overfill it. Oh yeah, there's my Perspex bodge on my lamp. Still not very bright, but... best I could do with what I'd got. Now this back plate were absolutely knackered. I did so much on it just to show him, but then I pulls off it. And he told me, he says, yeah, just do it anyway, because he's going to overplate it, so I end up doing it anyway. You just got to be careful with ricochet on these, just so that you don't splatter lights. You can get away with going around it like that, not a problem. especially with grit that I use. Same with wires and pipes and stuff, if you're ever worried about that. It all depends on the grit that you're using. Like this is medium grade crushed glass. So this is like ideal for just taking paint off an odd scab scale, maybe. You get a little bit of it, you know what you can see in video. But later on just through alley and route pipes and airbags and stuff like that. I do fly over it with a finer grade. It's like a super fine, like a talcum powder. And that it's a little bit forgiving on pipes and route lights and whatnot. Yeah, I left that bit because I needed to go to the other angle, but I didn't want to walk around it because there's little bits of wood all on the floor that pipes kept snagging on. I do come back the second day to do the insides, the internals. I've got it on video, but I don't think I'm going to put it up because it's a little bit boring. It's basically just doing this, but you're up and down and in and out with a ladder. Same again, this grit's not going to cause too much damage on seals and brakes and stuff like that. It's not too bad. Oh, them panels were getting cut off as well. That front panel on the front of the wagon gets cut off. Well, it's going to cut it off, it says. It's getting converted to, I think it's a tatey peeler, this machine. This wagon is getting into a mobile tatey peeler. Not something to do with taties, I'm not sure. Shows a bit grit valve again. Not much room under this wheel arch, so it's quite hard to try and remember what camera's looking at and what I'm looking at, and trying to keep your face out of the way of blowback. if you've got your face in the wrong place, it'll just ruin visor in no time. Yeah, that's a visor gone. Some place that's getting changed. Yeah, and that's it, we're coming to the end of the video. Don't forget to like and comment, then I know what to do for the next video. I can only go on your feedback, so comment, subscribe, and like.